So one thing I want to emphasize in this part of the lecture is that the basic element we want to be able to do analysis on most of the time in a 3D scene is rays of light. And we want to be able to use the rays of light to be able to extract information. So here's a beautiful image of a sun that actually, if you see this image, basically all of the rays of light are coming in. And we want to be able to kind of model a lot more information about how rays of light from this light source are hitting different parts of a scene. And of course, it's because of the phenomenon of this being hit, or these tree branches being hit, and us being able to see it, that kind of gives us the more visual feel of the scene. So we've looked at previously, and we've talked about the whole concept, that basically an image is a 2D array of pixels. And that's how we actually capture a 3D scene into a 2D image. But we want to remember that the fundamental primitives, at least in the whole analysis of a picture of computational photography process, is rays. We want to be able to kind of look at information that's coming and hitting the scene, and then, of course, getting reflected. And we want to be able to capture as much information from the environment based on the illumination and the rays that are hitting the scene. One of the things that's important when you start thinking about rays of light is that basically they follow a path from the source to the scene. So therefore, we can start using things like geometry of the rays of light to be able to extract information about what the scene is like. And more importantly, what we are interested in is how we can actually use computation that can control all parameters of how the optics and the sensor, that is the way the process of illumination goes, the rays of light, to go through optics to the sensor that actually allows us to generate those pixels that we can do image processing on. So one of the important things for us to remember now is that we want to be able to use computation to control how the illumination, which would then create the rays of light, that would be then controlled again with the optics to create information on a sensor that would generate the pixels that we actually will be doing processing on to be able to generate an image.